Hello. This week's Sedra is Sedra's KiTisah. Do the clothes make the man or does the man make the clothes? Similar to a chicken and egg question, there's no definitive answer to this question as well. The argument can be made that clothes are only a superficial vestment for the human body, which itself is only a superficial attire for the soul. But what if an argument could be made that clothes are more significant than what was first assumed? In our Torah portion, Hashem said to Moshe the following, say to the Israelite people, the Jewish people, you are a stiff-necked people. If I were to go in your midst for one moment, I would destroy you. Now, take off your fine clothes and I will consider what to do to you. In his commentary to this pasuk, Rabbeinu Hananel says an amazing thing. He explained that the clothes that Hashem commanded the Jewish people to take off were the clothes that had the blood of the covenant on them. This was the blood of the offerings that the firstborn gave at Har Sinai. The clothes were called the Edut, the testimony to the Israelites, and they were a great honor to be worn because this was a sign of the acceptance of God's covenant. Rabbeinu Hananel is alluding to an earlier episode in the Torah that many are not familiar with. It says as follows, Moshe wrote down all of God's commands. Early in the morning, he set up an altar at the foot of the mountain, at the foot of Har Sinai, with 12 pillars for the 12 tribes of Israel. He designated some young men among the Israelites, and they offered burnt offerings and sacrificed bulls as offerings of well-being to God. Moshe took one part of the blood and put it in basins, and the other part of the blood he sprinkled against the altar. Then he took the record of the covenant and read it aloud to the people. And they said, all that God has spoken, we will faithfully do. Moshe took the blood and sprinkled it on the people and said, this is the blood of the covenant that God now makes with you concerning all these commands. Rabbeinu Hananel explained, the blood was put on the people so that they could enter into a covenant with God in blood. It was literally sprinkled on the clothes. The same stain of blood on their clothes the Torah called testimony, for they were a witness and a great honor. The clothes were testimony and a sign that they entered into the covenant of God. When Bnei Israel sinned with the golden calf and violated the covenant, God said to them, take off your testimony. The same clothes that they used as testimony was removed from them. It was the same garments on which the blood of the covenant was thrown was a testimony and a sign between God and the people. Why did God make a covenant with them in blood? It was a hint to them that if you keep the Torah, it will be good for you. And if not, I will allow your blood to be cut down and die. Clothes can just be superficial coverings that mean nothing. Yet clothes can be so much more than meaningless coverings. While clothes can never create or strengthen our relationship with God, clothes can represent our relationship with God. At Har Sinai, the Jewish people's clothes, stained with the blood of the covenant, represented their relationship with God. When they severed their relationship with God, they were forced to lose those clothes. Many people criticize today's obsessions in the Torah world with clothes, from Hasidim in their 1800s costumes to seminary strict rules regarding skirt and sleeve length. It seems clothing can be a priority in the Torah world. As easy it is, though, to criticize what seems to be an obsession with the superficial, there is something meaningful about being careful with the details of Torah law. This isn't an obsession, but rather being careful to represent God in all aspects of our lives. And that is something commendable. Shabbat Shalom.